1, 2.
Yo, it's Mike Lowry.
She's a super, super, super model. Can't get away from Molly. She got me feeling like
Mike Lowry, what you saying, boys? Before we even start this interview, yeah, you lot, I went to your gig, O2 Islington.
I was there,
I was like the tallest player there. Really. But before you were saying that, like, you know, girls are not the main people at your gigs, innit?
Yeah.
Don't lie.
Statistics overall.
Yeah. How many boys did you see? There'll be a few.
I saw like five men. I saw five men.
There was quite a few boys to see men.
Yo, look.
To see boys.
Don't have boys and men. There's bare girls in
there. Yeah,
there is. There's girls, but I'm talking. Half of the crowd still men, son.
Half the crowd?
No.
No, the little.
I can't. I don't see on
screen. It was 95% girls.
Yeah.
Five men. Supermodels is out September 25th, yeah?
It's out now.
See, some people are saying September 25th, now you guys are saying it's out now.
Yeah?
So
yeah, it's
been out now for 4 weeks.
3 weeks.
3 weeks.
Yeah, the video's dropped already, yeah.
And the remix DP is out as well, so there's a Z.remix with Lady Leisha and
All About She
remix as well.
Which one's your favourite remix out of all of them?
Stay Neutral. Nah, All About She.
One person's already committed, you know.
I'm a house.
I like both.
Yeah.
I like the
Z.remix. What do you like? I like the bridge version. Yeah. I like the vision.
Cold.
Yeah.
You're a big
English
fan.
Yeah,
the Z, that one was sick.
Yeah.
You know, so
2Z.2
All About
You. I like the original.
How do you feel about the buzz about the track, though?
Yeah, it's getting hype. Everyone's hyping about it.
Everyone loves it, which is sick.
We're getting some good support as well for the track itself.
Yeah. Big up all the support, to be able to have all them those collabs that we've been able to get as well has been sick.
Yeah. Any chicks on your DMs already about that? Yeah.
Supermodel. Oh yeah, it was that about me.
It is about every one of them girls.
It is. Any girl out there, Supermodels is about you.
Wow.
I know. Slide into my DMs. You don't have to slide into my. Slide into our DMs.
Why are you trying to make it a team thing, bro?
I'm not selfish, bro. I'm all about the team.
Why are you lying? Why are you always lying?
Well done, boys.
It's just shame that you're lying. That's deep, isn't it? All right, so favorite supermodel then? Individually, not group decision.
Kara.
Your favorite?
That blonde girl. Kara, she followed us.
Alright, so you got Wiley on the track as well. Why did you choose him to be on like the feature or the track?
Because he's the godfather of grime.
he's like a legend within the whole UK music scene.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I mean I'd be a bit mad to say no.
One of them as well, like obviously he's massive in the grime scene, but he's actually been one of those artists that's managed to smash it in the grime scene and be commercially as well, which is a hard thing to do, especially a grime artist as well, to achieve that.
That's amazing.
Do you think it's opened up like a new fan base for you lot as well?
Definitely.
I think like with the Z.remix is like a bit more of a harder grind thing, and with Lady Leisha as well, and like that got played on Mr. Jam show.
It's just got played before.
Picking up loads. So like for DJs who like their show is mainly grime and that, and they wouldn't necessarily play our stuff because it's probably a bit too R&B. Like it opens us up to be able to.
I'm
at the gigs.
Sweets to see the playing as well. Trust me, been there from day one.
All I'm gonna say is, where's my follow on Twitter?
You don't follow your Twitter?
We are Mike Lowry following your Twitter.
Individually.
It's hard.
Do you follow us individually?
Yeah, bro. Alright, fine. After this, I'll follow all of you.
Okay, yeah, fine, then we'll follow you back. Okay, we'll follow you back.
Alright, who's the funniest guy in the group, though? And who's the most moody?
Am I?
Both, he's both.
He's
both funny and moody.
Yeah, he is.
Did you just point at me?
No,
it's
okay.
Oh, yeah.
Don't stop beef.
Yeah, he's both funny and moody. His moodies are funny.
He's bipolar. His mood swings can be a bit extra.
Yeah, I get a bit extra.
Yeah, you haven't said much so far, you know. You keep it so quiet.
I'm just like...
no punching, no violence, okay? You let's keep your calm.
Calm me on my ass. He probably loses the most out of everyone, but you can't stay mad at him because
he's a nice person.
Is that why you're on the other side?
Yeah.
Alright, so you guys are kind of like famous for the covers and stuff as well. When you had a gig, then you were doing quite a few covers, mixing in with some new stuff as well. Mm-hmm. Do you think the covers have actually helped you kind of like get signed?
Yeah, especially the Beyonce one.
Yeah. That's almost a million now,
isn't it? Why can't I keep my fingers off it, baby? Baby, I want you. Oh no. Why can't I keep my fingers off?
Day one went viral, you know what I mean? So that was a big tune at the time as well. As soon as Beyonce dropped their album, every single person was gassed.
Yeah.
Like the videos and everything about it was ham, you know what I mean? She funded it all herself. It smashed it. So we done the video. We didn't expect it to go viral at all. We just done the cover, you know what I mean? And we just put it out there.
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, page illegal music, and then all these pages just started sharing it, and the next thing you know, it just went boom, straight away. And then I had pure people messaging me, like personal people, like, yo, seeing your cover, and I was just like, what? And then we eventually all just jumped on it, you know what I mean, promoting it, sharing it.
That's but when we look back at it now, we like that video.
We hate it now.
You guys were in it though, innit? That's why you're thinking.
Yeah.
Everyone's critical of their own work.
Yeah, it is. Like, I'm going to back to this and hate my voice, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I look back and hate what we're wearing. I'm like, oh my god.
What are you wearing?
This is swag, right? You know what I mean?
There's no swag. We don't have any swag battles in this year. Right? Apart from the bucket hat, which is it.
Jeez.
Like,
your hat, man.
What does that? Yeah, what does that mean?
I've got no idea.
Exactly.
Slave to the fashion. The worst thing is, I don't even know what language.
Yeah, it looks.
Let's see.
I don't even know.
It looks. Like, it's like half Arabic, half Thai.
Yeah, it's Arabic. No, it's definitely Arabic.
It's not all Arabic.
It's not all Arabic.
At least it's not white.
If anyone watching this knows what language this is,
leave it in the comments
below.
Send us some stuff. Definitely Arabic. Definitely.
Alright, so obviously One Direction are splitting up in March, isn't it? So there's that vacancy for like, you know, top UK.
We in there, y'all.
Already said it. But you know, obviously, like Supermodels, it's a bit different from Tuxedo.
Yeah.
It's got like a bit of a more pop vibe to it at the same time.
I think with the whole, like, the different vibes and the whole 1D thing, it's like, even if 1D was still doing a thing past March or whatever, I still think we carry on with what we do.
It's a different kind of...
Different kind of vibe, and that's with the Tuxedo and Supermodels, it's like, it just shows our different tastes in what we do. You know what I mean? So we enjoy both of those songs and we enjoy what we do. I mean, I'd say Supermodel's a bit more poppy than Tuxedo, but I wouldn't say it's pure, like, you know, click your fingers.
It's still very much our sound. And
Definitely.
It is different to Tuxedo, though. Yeah, it is different, but.
Got a grind and house.
Yeah, the remixes and stuff brought it through as well.
Yeah.
It's the kind of stuff we like, so.
That's what you can do, make music that you like.
I like the fact that we explored with the grime bit. Like I was made up about that because I don't think any of our fans at that time, because the grime scene in Liverpool is not huge, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's there, but it's not huge anymore, it used to be. So we kinda took a new vibe for our fans as well, you know what I mean? Kinda opened up and showed them a little bit of grime. So I like that as well.
We did a cover of That's Not Me.
Yeah, that's not me as well, so you know what I mean?
Exactly, yeah. And if that spreads more around and stuff vibes, like that, then you're thinking about doing more grime in the future then?
Probably not more grime.
No, we're not going to start grime.
None of us can spit. Some of us can spit. I don't think we'd ever bring that to the table.
Yeah, we're not that good.
We're not rappers.
Never publicly.
I'm not a rapper.
But we'd love to do more collabs and stuff.
More covers of it. I mean, it's like said, stuff we like. So.
And I think it's a really good time for the grime scene in the UK at the moment. Like you can see how much. The Americans are starting to pick up on it now. You see how much Skepta's smashing it over there now.
So ideal collabs then?
Ooh. Skepta.
So, yeah, I've seen Skepta absolutely shut Crept and down as well. Crowds.
Crepta and Conan. Yeah. Yeah.
But like in other terms, it'd be like Quabs.
Quabs. Yeah.
Shaka.
Shaka, Blue Robinson. Disclosure.
Like yeah,
Disclosure. Ed Sheeran.
Jesse J.
Yeah,
everyone basically. If you want to get at us.
They're all different musicians, you know what I mean? Yeah. So they could all, like, when you sit in a room with more musicians, everyone can bring something different to the table, and I think that's what it is with us.
That's what helps you grow.
Exactly what it is. So we want to work with all these people because we want to bring something new to the table as well.
So have you got features on the album coming up?
We can't reveal anything like that. Yeah, because there's still so much. Like, the album will probably be coming out to like start of next year.
Yeah. So things can change dramatically.
But we're excited. Like, loads of the tracks are already done. So like, definitely. It's frustrating for us because we want
to bring it. We've been listening to them for times. Like.
We're gonna end it here. It's your boy Myles. That was Mike Lowry.
Yeah.
Peace.